Okay, so I just got finished marking this one, so I'll show you my setup for marking the next one. And you'll notice that I have a bandage on my finger. I sliced the top of my knuckle off right here last night. Marking these, it was 9 o'clock. I shouldn't have been out here, and I'm, you know, doing this, and the wood is so hard, and it just, I'm not even really sure how it happened. I was doing it this way, and it was, I'm not sure, but I just wham, came across, and it was ugly. It was ugly, and it still hurts like crazy. And so, just a stupid mistake. You know, I'm usually good for about once a year, giving myself a really good wing ding with a chisel or a, you know. Well, the last one I had was when I went to Chicago. I tore my hand, this right here, I tore my finger open on the lid of a toolbox, jamming a heavy toolbox, the latch, and that was incredibly painful. But, you know, you work around stuff enough, things are going to happen. Just try to be, you know, try to keep your hands out of the machines. That's the one thing, you know. Chisels and stuff, sure, they're bad, but they're not like having your hand caught in a table saw or a shaper or something that's joiner. Okay, so I'm just using these little miter clamps. So I'm going to take this guy out, and I've got everything marked, but I'm going to show you the whole sequence when I do this here, so you can get an idea how this is going down. So remember when I cut my tails, I have out, and now I can decide whether I want it up or down. And you know, a couple of these I had to recut because I had some damage or I miscut them. And I think I'll have this one up, and so this will be out. The nice thing about using these little guys is that it holds them in place. I'm going to kind of say this is going to be the front. I see a little bit of weirdness here, so I'm going to flip this around. There's out. This is going to be up. Let that weird tail down there be the back. And okay, I'm going to let this piece here with the mineral streak in it be the back. And now I can determine in and out. And I like to let the crown be this in this orientation. So this will be the front. I have never seen anything so earthy as this live oak. Like I said, I've turned a bunch of it, but I've never made any furniture or wood assemblies out of it before. But this is some really stunning stuff. And hard. That's probably why I cut my finger, as I was trying to really mark into the... Well, I can't blame it on the live oak. That's a cop-out. I cut my finger because I was doing something stupid. But the wood is so incredibly hard, I was trying to maybe overcompensate to get my good mark, and you know, just foolishly let that piece wing ding off of there. So you just want to get a rough setup here and get it a little bit finger tight, and then I get a clamp on the top, kind of pinning it together. It's going to help me get my alignment going. Just again, light. And I have a little bit of bow in some of these fronts and backs, so I'm using a cleat. And so I did the big drawers first so I can keep using the same cleat and just keep cutting it, just keep cutting them down. So here I'm gonna look here. That's where my mark is for my cleat. And I've got all four of these guys, and I'm gonna just walk over here to the table saw. I got my cross cut setup going here. I'm gonna put this other insert in. So you do the big one first, and then you just can keep chopping the same cleat down to make it work. So I put this here on the inside. Here, that clamp probably goes over here. Here I can just use this oak one. They're a little narrower, so this clamp is already set up for this. And so I can just reach over here, and I can just pull that panel absolutely flat for when I'm making my mark here. This looks like a wider one. See, this method that I'm using here, where I can go back in, like there were several. This one I think I'm gonna put on the outside because it's bowed the other way. Flatten it out. Oh yeah. Oh, that means my clamp's gonna be in the way. Well, I'll just have to, let me just move this clamp over, and I'll just have to. Around it. There we go. That pulled it absolutely flat now. I'll just put the clamp in here like this, and I may have to move it when I'm working on it, marking it. But anyway, like I said, I had to recut a couple of these tails where I had maybe let the saw drift a little bit, or I had some damage. But the beauty of this method is that you have the ability to come back in and recut these tails until they're just perfect, and you're not cutting your pins until you're happy with the way your tails are laid out. So a little bit of minor variation, since we're marking the pins directly off the tails, it'll be perfect. And a little bit of variation over this many dovetails is never noticeable. Plus, it just, you know, it gives things that handmade look too, instead of it just being so uniformly laid out like a dovetail jig. So that K-body Vario has that thin thing, so I was in a long jaw, so I was able to kind of reach around that guy and get it in place. Move this guy over just a little bit, give me some room to tap in there. Thank you. beauty of this wood is you can rap on it with a hammer and you're not making any dents in it. It's some tough stuff. Happy with that. Tighten these guys down. Let me check that far corner over there that I can't reach over across the table. Okay, now you just take your knife and try not to cut your finger wide open like I did, and you just come in here and you just carefully scribe. And you know, when you scribe, that's what I was doing. I was trying to do too hard last night. You do it light, create a little micro valley for the knife to ride in, and then when you cut it deeper, it has that to follow. If you try to do it too hard at the beginning, you can get it to drift. And just make sure you don't miss any. So just mark all of, my convention is I do all the tops, then I sit down on my chair and I reach under and I get all the bottoms.